We're on the road again, traveling the country coast to coast to check out the latest in decarbonization. This week, we're in beautiful Cleveland, Ohio, where our partners have lots of solutions to share. Let's rock and roll! Here we are in the historic Westside Market.
Historic is right. This place has been operating for like 100 plus years.
Definitely a rich history.
Yeah, absolutely. Do we see what our stop is for today?
Let's find out.
Hi, Bree. Hi, John. Today I'm excited because you get to visit the city of Cleveland. Cleveland is prioritizing decarbonization from the top down. They've been a longtime Better Buildings partner, and I know their commitment to decarbonization is citywide. I want you to go check in with Cleveland and give me a full report on what's going on in the land.
And being here in the city of Cleveland, this is actually where the phrase rock and roll was coined originally.
Did you know that? You're gonna say it, aren't you?
Well, let's rock and roll.
Welcome to Cleveland.
My goodness, thank you for having us.
Good to see you. What do you think of our fine city so far?
It's wonderful, beautiful city. Right? So can you tell me a little bit about what Cleveland's decarbonization goals are?
We want to decarbonize Cleveland block by block, building by building, neighborhood by neighborhood, to really show that we're serious and that Cleveland will be not just a national leader, but a global leader in this movement. When I took office last year, we made it a goal to make sure we reduced our climate footprint. We want to make sure we're at net zero carbon emissions by 2050. We're excited to be a part of the climate challenge with you all, making sure we decrease our carbon emissions by 50% by 2030. Yep. Always keeping the residents in mind to have clean, safe, healthy communities all across the great city of Cleveland, Ohio.
Definitely.
Exactly.
So I hear you all are going all across the city. My director of sustainability, Sarah, is that correct?
Sounds like it.
Well, you might need a special passport from the mayor. How about this magnet for the,
oh my God.
For the car?
Yes, I like the swag. So we are at the City of Cleveland's Kennel. The Kennel is an example of what we're doing with all major renovations and new builds across city facilities. We have a solar-ready roof. We have highly energy-efficient systems. We're thinking about the fit with the neighborhood and thinking about how it fits into the 15-minute city and the walkability, access to transit. We have a public transit line on this side. We have bike lanes here along the road. The sustainable building policy is really something that helps weave all of these efforts together into the fabric of decarbonization for the city.
Are there any surprising features about the building that folks might not be aware of?
Our sustainable building policy focuses on stormwater management as an opportunity. And here at the Kennel, we've installed an underground cistern that helps harvest the rainwater. And we also have stormwater management here in this park that decreases the need for the use of stormwater systems and also the use of municipal water. Welcome to Frederick Douglass Neighborhood Resource and Recreation Center here in the Lee Harvard neighborhood. Similar to all of our other new builds or major renovations, this follows the sustainable building policy. It has a lot of energy efficiency features. We have highly energy efficient heating and cooling systems. We have a cool roof that is also solar ready. When we say climate justice, we're really thinking about locating decarbonizing features and resilience features to climate change here right in the neighborhood. It's important that the community is ready to participate not only in benefiting from clean and green technologies, but also in getting jobs. We have youth education programs in STEM all over the community, including at museums and in our school system.
Dodd and Bree, we are so excited to have you at Great Lakes Science Center.
So Kirsten, what are we looking at here at the environmental dashboard?
This has been a really creative way of integrating in the arts and engagement into getting the public to look more at data. And that's what the dashboard is all about. We're trying to get people to feel comfortable making their energy use data just a public part of what they do.
So what kind of data can we see here?
Let's look at energy usage. And what it's going to pull up is just what we've been doing in the building. So live data usage at the Science Center. You see this spike happening right here, everybody coming into work. We love it because it helps us set a norm, right? That's that green line. We know what our norm is. And the challenge for us is, can we get our norm to come down? I mean, that's the real challenge, right? Like that long-lasting change over time, right?
What grade are you guys?
Ninth
grade, okay. I think we've got some questions for you guys. Who knows what a greenhouse gas is?
So greenhouse gases are the gases that are stuck between the Earth and the atmosphere.
So what kind of impacts do they have on the Earth?
They kind of heat up the planet if, you know, they spill out, and then, you know, that kind of melts the icebergs and causes flooding very often.
Yeah.
If there's one thing you could say to everybody in the world about climate change, what would it be?
It can be really easy to get discouraged and just to feel like it's a really big problem. But what I think everybody needs to know is that everybody in this room, all of us have the power to make an impact and to do something, to reduce energy use, to reduce emissions, and just know that, you know, you can really make a difference. It's really nice to meet you all. Give yourselves a hand.
Yes, crushed it, you guys.
I was really impressed with those kids, and they all are working on a capstone project, and they had some interesting projects that were really meaningful to them and the things that are affecting them and their communities.
Well, I was particularly impressed by the variety of building types that the city has and the varying pathways that they're taking on their emissions reduction journey.
Excited to see where we end up tomorrow.
Me too.